Hey guys, yeah, I'm on my way. I'm just trying to figure out where you're at.
Alright, no problem. We'll see you soon.
Thanks, man. Yeah, just be sure to look out for some creepy dude I saw in the forest earlier. He's dressed kind of weird and creepy looking.
Not Jason Voorhees, is it?
Yeah, real funny, Matt. Jason Voorhees only exists in films. He's just a legend. I'll see you guys soon.
Alright, we'll see you soon. On his way.
Where is Alex?
I don't know. He's talking about some weird dude walking in the woods.
Ah! No.
You guys know the legend of Jason Voorhees is true, right?
You're so full of shit, dude. Everyone knows Jason Voorhees is all in the movies. You guys need to get a grip.
I'm open-minded to Jason Voorhees, it's true.
Thanks, Jill. At least someone has an imagination.
Come on, guys. Let's just get along and hang out for the weekend.
What's going on, Josh?
What's wrong?
Alex is dead, Joe's dead, Dana. They're all dead, man.
Where did this happen?
Camp Crystal Lake. They all secretly went camping. Hi. Come inside, Larry. Let's chat a little. I can't be outside right now. Who bloody killed him, lad?
Relax, Ryan. Authorities are still trying to figure that out, man.
But Matt didn't even tell us he was going anywhere.
I wanted you to hear it from me, man. I came over here for that. We just gotta be there for him, man. Alright, man. I have to go. I just wanted to tell you that, okay? Just relax, man. Let me know if you need anything. Alright? Talk to you, man.
Today will be a memorable day for the ones we've lost. Losing friends, families, loved ones, it's never easy. We've lost some amazing people. But their memories will never be forgotten. Today on this holy day, we will all cherish these souls and give our blessing. My heart goes out to everyone for such a terrible loss. Thank you everyone for being here on this day. I wish you all the best.
Matt's not here.
What an asshole. Matt is such a coward for not showing up.
You ought to be there for Matt.
I think he may kill himself. Honestly, I had a friend who did that when he was 18 over some girl.
I mean, he can't go down like that. I don't want to see him go down like that.
Me neither, Dan. Crazy, though. Still haven't found Jason's body since last summer.
He beat you to it. I read that text. At least wherever he is, you're not the one who sent him there. It's your fault, but he died better than anything you would have ever done.
Sorry, Sid. I don't feel this hurting.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Mayor Williams. I just want to inform the American people and the citizens of our community that I am shutting down Camp Crystal Lake forever. The lake has been nothing but a source of trouble. So many lives have been lost there. There is so much pain. But it all stops today, right now. The memories that haunt people today of those deaths are exactly why I'm closing the camp today. No one can cross the path to enter the camp. You will be electrocuted. The world changes today.
Who wants a Guinness?
Fantastic work, youngsters. I don't have to look over my shoulders anymore.
You see we're working here, right?
Can I talk to you in private, please?
Sure, I don't mean to be interfering.
Not interfering with anything. I just want to let you know that Matt is going through a lot right now. He doesn't need any mistrust, especially from the staff and yourself. And I'm willing to quit my job if you keep acting like a smartass.
I'm sorry. I don't mean to be a smartass.
I don't know.
Matt, we're there for you if you need us.
It will get better, man. Just take a little bit of time.
Yeah, Matt. I'm proud of you, man. Keeping it together. Staying strong. It's the Matt we know.
And Matt, I'm sorry if I embarrassed you anyway when I talked to Dolly.
No, not at all. What did you say to him?
Well, I really wanted to tell him to go fuck himself, but what I said was, I'll quit my job if you keep it up with this bullshit, because nobody has time for that.
Shit, I love talking to you.
See? This is what we need. A good time with some humor.
Thank you guys for being here and making me laugh. Help me through the hardest time of my life.
I love talking to you guys, man.
Hey, Matt.
You're funny.
Can I speak to you in my office, please? I just need you for a couple minutes. Please?
No seat, please. Thank you so much for your help here, Matt.
I'm so sorry for all your losses.
Sir.
No one ever went through what you should have gone through, and I'm so sorry for you.
I appreciate that, sir. Thank you.
I don't mean to be a pain in the ass.
Can I go now, please? I don't mean to sound like a dick.
No. You should get back to work, and thank you for letting me speak to you today,
yeah.
Matt.
No problem.
Matt, we're there for you if you need us.
It will get better, man. Just take a little bit of time.
Yeah, Matt, I'm proud of you, man. Keeping it together, staying strong. It's the Matt we know.
I'm so sorry for all your losses,
sir.
You can do this. I love you, Matthew.
Thank you. girl named Casey Jill Roberts tried to kill a girl in her home with a Brandon James Ghostface Scream killer mask. Casey almost killed her, but a girl named Suzanne Becky defended herself with a kitchen knife and killed her. More news is expected soon about this case, but for now, I'm James Barry, reporting for Channel 100 News.
What are you trying to be, Ghostface?
No, more than that. You'll just have to wait and see, Suzanne.
Well, just to let you know, you sick and twisted bitch, I'm not gonna play any of your fucking games. You'll be dead before you can even lay an eye on me. You're a fucking scream freak.
We'll see, Suzanne. We'll see.
Whatever.
Suzanne, come out, wherever you are. I can hear you. Son of a bitch.
little mama heads there.
Sister Suzanne, she got the best of her. You killed her.
My twin sister? Really?
Yeah.
That's insane. These Ghostface and Scream copycats never end.
Casa su casa, did I say it right?
You fucking talk about it, it's okay.
What's really bothering you, brother?
Everything is fucked up, man. The manager is a fucking asshole. We might lose our fucking jobs.
It's not mostly importantly. Something's not right, man. Something's not fucking right.
Fuck that twat, Matt. Let's get a couple pints.
Give me the fucking Corona, man. Or whatever the shit you Irish motherfuckers drink.
No Mexican beer in my house.
Oh, you have your shit Irish shit.
That's right, that's right.
Your father made it with his feet.
It's some sheep.
Oh no, that's wine, man.
You gonna open this with your teeth or you got a bottle opener?
I'm gonna open it with your mama's nalgas. Give me. Motherfucker. Hello.
Wash it down good with a pint of blue.
Wait, let's try. I like that one better. Maybe.
I told you.
Órale, pendejo.
I got you, laddie.
Grow the fuck up, okay? And stop fucking calling me lad, puto. Cause I'm a fucking lad, you Irish bitch.
This is me, fucking puto.
Oh, it's glorious.
He's better than...
Better than sex. Pint in the morning.
Maybe your sex. My sex is spicy.
Spicy sex.
Salud, eh? Let's cheer. Our fucking shitty jobs.
May they stay shitty forever. Hey, we drink all the time in Ireland.
We also drink in fucking Mexico all the time. Mick lad.
Oh, there it is. Welcome to the team. You speak some Irish.
Thank you.
to see you again. I must be dreaming. You're
dead. Dead. Why can't I control my PTSD?
It's because you miss me. Anyone would go crazy after what happened to you.
It's all my fault.
I could have saved you, but I was too confused with everything going on. I should have believed in the legend, but I was too blind to see it.
Look at me. Look at me. Look at me. I'm dead. And there's nothing nobody can do to fix that.
What can I do?
Kill all your friends, go to Camp Crystal Lake, and end Jason Voorhees once and for all.
Jason's already dead. I can't kill him again.
What makes you so sure Jason's dead? You can do this. I love you, Matthew.
Tomorrow's Valentine's Day?
I know. When's your Valentine?
Well, you if you'd like.
Let's forget I even asked that question.
Still don't have a Valentine. No luck.
Me matey's excited for tomorrow. Take me to the big game, lads.
Awesome.
Absolutely awesome. Now, guys. Yeah.
Gotta
get back. One's over.
Thanks a bunch.
This is a good run.
The American Dream. Hey, ladies first.
Thanks.
Oh, Kara, happy Valentine's Day to you too.
Oh, man.
It's your unlucky day, motherfucker!
Once upon a time, on a sad valentine, in a place known as Antigermai, a legend began, every woman and man would always remember the ties. And those who remain were never the same, you could see the fear in their eyes. Once every year, as the 14th draws near, there's a hush all over the town. For the legend they say on a Valentine's Day is a curse that'll live on in night. And no one will know as the years come and go of the horrors of long time ago. Days came and went, and everyone spent in quiet regret. And those still alive know the secret survives in the darkness that looms in the night. For the legend they say on a Valentine's Day is a curse that'll live on at night. And no one will know as the years come and go of the horrors of some long time ago. Comes round, there's a silence and fear in the air. Remember the morn when the legend was born, all the shock and horror was there. For the legend may say on Valentine's Day, it's a curse that'll live on in mind. No one will know what the years come and go of the horrors.
As the years come and go.